key features of the TE12000 extractor. This TE12000 Tamisium extractor can hold 4 kilos of plant material and extract as fast as 5 minutes using a temperature range from as low or high as your supplied chiller heater can go. Common temperature range, negative 40 Fahrenheit to 120 Fahrenheit. With a non-looping process such as used by Tamisium extractors, it is not required to use ultra-cold temperatures to avoid lipids such as wax, tar, and other heavy viscous dark compounds. Lowering contact time to disable a solvent's effectiveness is chosen over lowering temperatures, however. Lower temperature extractions are not excluded. Using an adequate amount of solvent to perform a complete extraction allows you to send the appropriate amount of solvent through the plant material in one pass, as fast as you want, at any temperature with any combination of solvents. Recovering to loop it back through in the middle of an extraction process disables these controls. The most desired feature of the Tamisium design and process is said to be the prized multi-layered channel filter that courses the extract through over 15 to 30 feet of activated charcoal to decolorize and remove waxes from your extract so you can focus on adding heat and time back into the process and increasing yields. This filter is inline, sandwiched between the column bottom and the extractor top. It works seamlessly with no added time or labor to the process. Any range of plant volume can be used up to 4 kilos, such as half column or less capacities. Any volume of solvent can be used, but to perform a complete extraction, 4 volumes of solvent are recommended to 1 volume of plant column space. It is possible to overfill the column to perform a high-density extraction from finely ground material. 4 kilos is considered average density. Cold solvents can be added to the list of primary solvents to target specific compounds based on polarity matching. Primary solvent choices are not limited to butane, but butane is the lowest boiling point solvent you can choose that allows pump-free safe sanitary recovery using distillation. Any solvent with a higher boiling point than butane can be used and recovered with the same distillation process. Rapid recovery of the solvent is therefore through distillation. A large diameter evaporation tank provides ample recovery rates of 8 to 12 liters per hour set by the operator. 48 liters of total solvent volume is used, and 48 liters is what is required to perform a complete extraction from 12 liters of plant material. If an adequate amount of solvent is used, it may be required to recover the solvent and loop it back through the plant material. This will add extreme contact time between your solvent and plant matter. Adding contact time extracts high levels of wax, tar, dark compounds, and other heavy lipids found in plants. Added contact time requires ultra-cold temperatures to counter the effect of the extended contact time. By decreasing contact time and using mild cold temperatures, you can increase yields and the array of compounds extracted while also decreasing overall production times. If in doubt, be sure to watch the slideshow of all the products created with Tamisium extractors at the end of this video. The entire extraction is performed in liquid phase. Liquid solvents extract exponentially faster with more control and efficiency than when vaporized into a gas. This is due to a greater molecular density to form bonds and the ability of densely packed molecules to transfer heat and cold more efficiently. Liquid transfers cold and hot temperatures 20 times more efficient than gas and carries uniform mixtures of solvent through plant material when performing multipolarity extractions. The column filled with plant material is filled hydraulically from above using pressure and the solvent delivery tank. A 16-inch tank delivers 1,000 pounds of force with as little as 5 psi pressure. Hydraulically filling prevents channeling and allows temperature inputs. All relative pressure and vacuums are created by the solvent used. No pumps are necessary due to the careful, well-thought-out design of the patented design and process of a Tamisium extractor. The TE12000 can produce up to 200 grams of targeted extractions per hour of operation, and the process can be fully automated. Recipes can be stored, saved, and retrieved to share, sell, or enhance the ability of any extractor operator or apparatus by a worldwide network of users. Preloaded data can allow immediate production upon delivery with no learning curve. Optional key elements of the user data can be selected and shared on the network, such as yields, chemical identifiers, and analytical data, while selected private data can be omitted and remain invisible to the viewers, such as name, location, genus, species, and key extraction data. Tamisium extractor operators, wholesale purchasers, and consumers can privately contact extraction owner operators based on their performance and ability via a worldwide network, so that the end user of these medical compounds can gain access faster than ever before. Tamisium TE12000 Extraction Summary. The process begins with a pressure-checked full solvent delivery tank. The solvent has been placed in the tank and it has been pre-chilled or heated to the desired starting temperature. The solvent delivery tank has just recovered the solvent from a prior run and should be cold to start. For volatile extractions, we recommend normal butane that has been cleaned by distillation using the Tamisium extractor. Step 1. Attach your solvent delivery lines. Connect one end of the solvent delivery line to the top of the solvent delivery tank's liquid siphon center exit valve. Connect the other end of the solvent delivery line to the top of the column liquid center inlet valve. Step 2. Attach your recovery lines. Connect one of the three ends on the recovery line to the top of the column vapor outlet on the side and the top of the extractor tank vapor outlet as indicated. Connect the third end to the recovery line to the recovery tank vapor inlet valve. Step 3. Begin extracting. After your solvent or solvents have been combined and set to your desired solvent temperature in your solvent delivery tank, you can then use the heat input on the solvent delivery tank to create the head pressure to expel solvent from the liquid siphon line in the solvent delivery tank into the column of the plant material to prime with a full liquid saturation soak at any desired temperature for any length of time. Note: solvent temperatures will not increase by the heat used to create the head pressure so long as the solvent is allowed to expel from the tank during heat input. To perform a temperature-controlled extraction, leave the solvent delivery tank liquid outlet valve closed during heat input until you reach your solvent temperature setting commonly ranging from negative 40 to 120 Fahrenheit. To perform a low-temperature extraction, you can omit closing the solvent delivery valve. It can be left open until the solvent delivery tank is completely empty. As low as 5 minutes total contact times can be achieved before starting a full recovery of all the solvent from both the extractor tank and column of plant material. Why do all liquid solvent extractions require 4 times more solvent than the column will hold? The first volume of solvent that enters a column is the solvent that does 90% of the extraction. It has also absorbed into the plant matter and will not exit until the remaining solvent from the solvent delivery tank washes it out. The second volume mixes slightly with the first, and the third volume mixes slightly with the second, and so on. It is known that by the third and fourth volumes, very little desired compounds will remain in the plant matter. It is the third volume of the solvent that washes the plant clean of any dissolved compounds. The fourth volume stays in the plant matter and must be recovered from that position. Although these volumes are mentioned as separate actions, however, they flow through in one continuous cycle. Step 4. Soaking. Once you observe the solvent flow out the bottom of the column into the extractor tank, you can stop filling by closing the inlet valve on top of the column. Closing this valve creates a hydraulic vacuum on the top of the column that holds the solvent in the column area. The filter below prevents the liquid solvent from exiting the column. This will allow you to soak your column with solvent for a specific time at a specific temperature to target specific compounds. If no soak time is desired, keep the column inlet valve open until the solvent delivery tank is completely empty. Step 5. Starting recovery. Open the outlet valve in the extractor tank, the inlet valve on your recovery tank, and the connecting valves on both recovery tanks if both are being used to recover in a series. Using both recovery tanks cuts your recovery times in half by doubling the condensation surface area. Open the top column vapor outlet valve last until it has had time to drain sufficiently, preventing any solvent from bypassing the column. Be sure your extractor tank heater is set to 90 Fahrenheit to 110 Fahrenheit, and your column is 5 degrees warmer to help the heat penetrate into the plant matter. Remember, there is no liquid inside the column to help transfer those BTUs to the core. Although the column is smaller, it will take just as long to evaporate all the solvent absorbed inside. Key note: it is imperative to safety that all butane is evaporated from your column. The process is designed so the column finishes first so long as you use a 1:4 loading ratio. Step 6. Draining into the sucker dryer tank. Just prior to recovering all the solvent from the extractor tank, use what's remaining to drain your extract into your sucker tank, where the final phase of recovery can take place, after which the tank can be relocated to another work area, where it can be dried down to 0 parts per million readings of any trace solvent. Step 7. Closing the wafer valve and removing the column. While waiting to recover the final trace amounts of solvent into the same recovery tank from your dryer tank, you can break the system down to expel your spent column of plant material and reload it to perform another extraction. Or you can have a preloaded column ready to go. Emptying the column is an easy job, with the removable perforation plate that expels the column's content from below. If you have not closed your wafer valve already, be sure and close your wafer valve on your extractor tank to seal it so you can safely remove the column to prevent filling the work area with flammable vapors expelled from your extractor tank. This also prevents solvent loss from the solvents that filled and vapor locked your tank. The extractor tank is self-cleaning and will never need to be cleaned so long as you drain it into the sucker tank. It is common to perform as many as 5 extractions and 4 recoveries before opening the sucker dryer tank to access your finished product. This allows you to eliminate unnecessary steps involved in removing your product from the dryer tank when extracting repetitively from the same material. The sucker tank also serves as a dryer tank to clean your final product of all residual solvents. Step 8. Resealing and pressure checking any open tanks. Any open tanks will need to be pressure checked again. This will be the sucker tank once cleaned and resealed, and the column once filled and resealed. They are pressure checked again each time because those are the tanks that have had their seals broken. If you do not drain your extract out of the extractor tank into your sucker tank, you will need to reseal that tank and pressure check it after removing your extract from the extractor tank. Choosing not to drain your extract from the extractor tank into the sucker tank is not recommended for safety reasons, as well as inconvenience, time, labor, and overall cost.
Thank you. Thank you.